Lisa, this is Libby, Tom, and our project is based on the idea that there's a very big difference visually in the arousal of penis and the arousal of vagina. As the penile arousal is very visible, it's very apparent, whereas vaginal arousal is much more like secret, hidden, it's much easier to hide, which of course can lead in penile arousal to both embarrassment and shame if it happens at an inopportune time, but also to pride and joy, because even a sense of identity if it is really visible and really there. So we thought, what if we can translate that and somehow put those aspects of these very visual and apparent aspects of penile arousal and make them available to someone with a vagina. So basically we were thinking about the kind of input we could use. So we were thinking about using moisture or using pressure, one of which you can control and the other which you can't. And in the end we actually use both. And we were also thinking about the kind of output to use. So we thought about using virtual reality, some kind of avatar body that had some very visual show of arousal in some way. But in the end we went for hardware to have an actual physical thing on your body that shows the arousal. And another aspect is that you can take it very literally, like literally make a strap-on penis that gets erect based on the moisture sensor, for instance. But you could also make it a metaphor, for instance, make the flower, or in this case, a peacock tail. And of course, you could also take it really abstract, but we didn't find it really interesting that you make LEDs flash or something. Wasn't really the direction that we wanted to go in this time. And then, of course, the purpose. The purpose of it could be very functional, which I don't think is the right word, but let's say we're talking about a strap-on again, you could design it in such a way as you could actually have sex with it. However, it can also be used for something else. It could be very performative, but it's much more about showing your arousal to the world in a very creative and flashy way. And it could also, of course, it has an experiential aspect to it as well, that you experience the visual aspect of arousal, which usually don't
1 minute.
See as someone who has a vagina. So I want to very quickly talk about the environment here. Because of the last part, the experiential part sort of touches to a molecular flexibility, which is very interesting if any of you are interested in this stuff. It's basically the idea that your brain is very flexible as to what goes to the body or not. So you can add extra body parts, you can even add non-human body parts such as a tail, or in this case a peacock tail. And your brain actually sort of, as it reacts to actual input from the body, your brain actually starts to regard it as part of your body. So we have a prototype of an amoeba, two servo motors, one moisture sensor and one pressure sensor, and we'd like to show it.
So basically right now it's calibrated for and what happens is the moisture sensor determines how wide the tail goes, and if you use pressure, so if you would, for instance, constrict your muscles, then it makes a, does a little sort of dancing motion. So you have to, this is the pressure.
What's your inspiration behind this particular imagery of using like a bird?
Well, we were talking about like peacocks in general, like there's also pictures I showed that the tail of the peacock is very flashy and has a tail, and those tails can be like huge, like twice as big as the body of the peacock, whereas the peahen is very small and like much more brown, gray colored. So we felt like the parallel was really nice about the visual aspect of it. And we also, because we were talking about doing this raffle, and then we kind of like the idea of being very performative and being very, so that it would be very mechanical and have flashing lights and be very obvious, and this is sort of natural, so the next step beyond that, I think. I think we would like to make this big behind you and very good, and there was not really an option now.
So you could have a dildo that gets harder, more aroused a woman is, for example, like that.
Yeah, that was sort of the idea of the literal aspect of it, that you take it very literally and then maybe, you just wrap on or something like that. And we kind of just like the idea of the metaphor, that it doesn't be that obviously like related to things, and it would just be like, look at me, or something like that.
Sorry, I love this, except I'm not sure how practical it is if you have to wear it on the inside. It might even get in the way of action that could have happened if not. Do you think it's at all possible to measure a woman's arousal, or a man's for that matter, elsewhere on the body, like inside the genitals?
Definitely, you could use a heart rate sensor, for instance, for a very general measure of arousal, of course, then also get aroused from like laughing or in this case, I think, because the sensors are actually quite small, of course there would be something in there that would be like wires, unless you make it wireless. That is sort of also that way. So I think it would be possible this way. I think it would also very well be possible to do it with heart rate or something like that. Or with combine it with a side rod.